All praise is due to Allah, and may Allah raise the rank of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and protect his nation from that which he fears for them. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the great and blessed month has come, the month of Ramadan, the month of blessings. So complete this month with more acts of obedience. For the one who applies this time with acts of obedience will be successful, and the one who does not will miss out on all the great rewards. A month about which Allah the Exalted told us that the blessed Quran came down as guidance to the people, with clear proofs of guidance and criterion between right and wrong. It is the month of blessings and mercy, the month in which one should increase his acts of obedience by treating one's parents with kindness, displaying good manners, forgiving and showing mercy to others, and helping one another in working for the hereafter. Fasting is of great benefit to us. It teaches one to go against his bad inclinations. It also helps the slaves to show good attributes and stay away from the unlawful. With fasting, sins are forgiven. The Prophet of Allah, peace be upon him, advised us that the one who fasts the month of Ramadan in sincerity to Allah will have his sins forgiven. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, what means? Praying the five obligatory prayers, praying the Friday prayer one after another, and fasting the month of Ramadan year after year, will have one's sins committed between them forgiven as long as one stays away from the enormous sins. All should put in extra effort and give additional attention to the religious teachings, especially in this blessed month, in order to benefit family, friends, and neighbors. One should not say, I have taken a portion of this knowledge, and in turn lack the motivation to attend lessons and teach others. Teaching is amongst the best acts of worship today that will benefit one in the hereafter. This is mainly because ignorance and corruption is currently widespread. The one that does not acquire the personal obligatory knowledge destroys himself and could also destroy others. Allah places love for knowledge in the ones He willed well for. Those persons continue acquiring the knowledge without being sufficed with what they have acquired. Ibn Hibban narrated that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said what means. A believer will not be sufficed with the good he hears, that is the knowledge of the religion, until his final destination will be paradise. A worshipper without knowledge is in a great danger. He will not know whether he is praying correctly or not, nor would he know if his zakah and hajj are performed properly. Little amount of worship performed with knowledge is better than larger amounts performed with ignorance. The religious knowledge should be taken only from scholars to ensure protection from mistakes and distortions, and should not be acquired through simply reading books like many do today. Dear beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, take advantage of this blessed month of Ramadan. We ask Allah for protection and safety until the end of Ramadan, hoping for forgiveness of Allah, as the Messenger of Allah informed us that when the month of Ramadan arrives, the doors of paradise are open and the doors of hellfire are closed. The head devils are chained and a lot of people are forgiven during this month of Ramadan. May Allah grant us safety from hellfire and make it easy for us to fast, to wake up at night and perform acts of obedience, and to keep ties with the family, by the virtue of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the best of the creations, and Allah knows best.